Nor the Mess. I wanted to kind of show off a little bit of what I've been working on the last couple of days. And like every good hoarder, we have a plethora of whatever you might need. You need a toy gator? We got that. I wanted an awning for the bus, and I wanted it to be fully adjustable. And so I have designed that. Just thought about it quite a bit and decided that this is what I wanted to go with. I wanted it adjustable height-wise, as well as I wanted it to be able to slide out and back towards the bus. So that took some doing, and I did not want to drill any holes in anything. So everything works by counter pressure, and it is just mocked up right now. I don't have it completed. The awning doesn't even have a tie-off, so right here will be a Velcro tie-off on the awning itself. There will not be multi-colored paracord tying that off. It's going to be a leather strap or something like that. But temporarily, this is what we have. The scallops just attach by magnets. On the back side, we have this steel galvanized tubing, and then I just used tent poles, an old tent that I had, and they need, where the blue tape is, they need new bungee cord inside, or shock cord, so I've ordered that, and we'll tie that off and get those in there. The welds aren't done, not finished, everything's just tacked. Wanted to see if it was even strong enough to hold itself up, self-supporting, and I just cut a plate, essentially, that is counter pressure. And then there's a piece of smaller diameter galvanized inside that arm on that location. And also up here you can see it sticking out right there. And this is just slightly unlevel. And you can see where that one is based on where the screws, relative to the screws in the tilt supports and the hoop set supports. And then here we're quite a bit above, and we've actually dropped off to where that tilt support narrows to the 3/4 inch. So what I'm going to do on this one is go in, and right here on this lower portion, I'm just going to shave off a little bit of that so we can drop that down to level, because the front side here is just a little bit taller and it'll bug me. It's just not sitting level. I don't mind that the two arms aren't the same, that doesn't bother me. But I do want the awning itself to sit level. Go around here, maybe you can kind of see what I mean there. So you can see the cab, where the cab is, the cab side, so I can do this without dropping the camera here. This side here is just a little bit high. So I just need to notch out that pocket that it's sitting in to drop that down just a hair. It probably won't even take an eighth of an inch to drop that. Backside is perfect, it's dead level, so we just need to make the whole thing match that. And it's not terrible, but it's gonna bug me. So I'm gonna fix it. Fix it now while we can. And then we'll come off of this guy here, where that little aluminum thing is, and we'll tie a string back if we have a real windy day or something like that, just to keep it. But it's pretty stout. I mean, I was pretty impressed with to be self-supporting and not have to tie it off anywhere. I'm pretty happy with that. And it is fully adjustable. I don't know if I can do it one-handed. I may have to turn the camera off temporarily, but it will slide all the way back to the bus. And the other thing is the tilt, the canvas that's already on there, I can unlash that and reach up and latch over the awning. I can drop this down height-wise too so that it matches it just perfectly. But I was trying to get it up where I could work with it so I wouldn't be constantly bumping into that already on there canvas. I didn't want to damage it any if I could help it. So kind of where this gap is here, right there, will be a Velcro strap. We'll have a Velcro strap here to pull that tight, and we'll have one in the back also, and then on each each corner so that we can make sure that that topper isn't gonna fly off here. So shoot you up on top here. So that's what it looks like up on top. I did have to make a seam in the middle. I didn't want to order new fabric. This stuff is not cheap. But I love it, and I had those two big sections left, so I just went ahead and sewed those together the best I could and make do with what we got. I'm all about that. I'm gonna have to go through and wire wheel my buckles and oil them. They rusted, unfortunately. Stainless ain't what it used to be. I have to go back and fix that. Just thought I'd show what I had so far. These are the ends. Are the little 90s that aren't really 90s. If you buy a true 90, it has kind of a sharp point, and they're $4 for 90 something a piece at Lowe's. Those in there are only, they're less than $2. They're like $1.60 or something like that. So works a lot better. Doesn't have the sharp corners. But I am happy to share any measurements I have here on this. It's going off of my tilt setup. So I built that tilt frame and tilt setup. By tilt, I mean the canvas topper that's on the back of the truck. But it is built off of the factory points. I didn't drill anything new, so it's where it should be down here. My hoops may not be exactly what yours are, but all you would have to change is this bracketry here. I mean, it's not that big a deal. I probably should have built the awning set out of square tube, but I didn't have square tube. Lots of galvanized that I got for free. So that's what we're building it out of. Nothing is pinned or secured. I didn't drill any holes through any of this armature here. So if this gets bumped or slides or whatever, it's going to move. I probably will put a pin in the one that's on the truck to keep that from getting hit or bumped. And the one on the top I eventually will as well, just because I don't want the wind to lift it off of there and fly it across. So it will be pinned, it just isn't right now. Don't know that I'll make the slider portion of it be pinned, but I'm going to see if we can have catastrophic camera failure. Let's see if we can set this camera up somewhere, and let's slide that back if we can. It's really cold out here today. I say really cold. For April. Indians are fighting it. We have not had a warm day yet, in my opinion. Let's see. Bad thing about setting something on a beetle. There's nothing square. Oh, sorry about that. Let me turn you off and turn you right back on. I don't know how well y'all can see that. And probably going to get up there and this camera's going to go flying because I have me balance on the roof rack. Pardon my appearance. Let's see if we can shove on that a little bit. That's probably about as far as we can go. But it will go perfect. Touch into, oop, we lost a magnetic alignment there. The magnets just kind of shoved up. So we would have to, I'd have to move those back. But that's about as far as I would want to go back with it currently without it being leveled out a little bit. And that's good. It's a good height if you're at an art show or something and want people bumping their heads. See how far we can bring it back. Now comes the test. Now's when it breaks on camera. Magnets are freaking me. Let me get that moved and turn the camera back up. So that is the furthest, well, all but about a half inch. The furthest it'll go, and definitely if you move it, you're going to have to move the magnetic scallop strip. I just took it off because it gets caught in the little slider. Note to self, make sure I move that. But it's pretty strong even out that far. I'm pretty surprised, and I don't have it, it's just tack welded, so it's not even as strong as it's going to be. But I'm pretty happy with how it's turned out. I'm glad I didn't have to drill any holes. And there's no, you don't have to have any support poles out in the yard. You can just support yourself off the bus. And if I decide I want it a little bit lower and I want to bring over the tilt that's already in existence, I can do that. I am going to consider putting it on a pivot so that if there's, you know, I need a different sunshade direction or something like that, I can pivot it. That's going to take some thinking on my part. I think all in all, this design is pretty good. If I need to tilt this design for rain, I can just drop one of the arms down lower than the other, and it should be fine. So that's what we've got. That's the project I'm working on. Going to finish that up tonight, hopefully, except for the shock cord. And then I'm going to jump to a few other things. A couple of those being... Get the camera out of here. A couple of those being... Again, I said ignore the mess. I got a couple of really good chairs. I don't know if those are coming through or not. Got one up there as well. Hanging. And then that one I was standing on. Super cool. Picked those up at the salvage yard. So this guy here has a little tray inside. Has a few condition issues. It has a bend in one of the legs that I think will beat out just fine. Gonna put a leather seat on those and take those to a vintage market we're doing in a couple of weeks. So I gotta get on those. I have a couple of other things too that we're gonna work on. But all in all, I'm happy with the way this awning turned out, and happy to share that with you if you have any interest in learning how I did it. I think I will be needing that piece of nastiness and more, so let's get rid of that. Can you tell it was on a Volkswagen? Or at least an old seat. That's what I was riding on prior to redoing the seats, but that's going bye-bye. It's trash pickup day tomorrow, and it's getting tossed.